Hi, my name is Mark Andrade. I'm an assistant principal at Fallon Memorial Elementary School located in Pawtucket, Rhode Island. And I asked the question, what are the communication barriers within our school? So I looked at technology and families and asked families what they recommended would be the best methods in communicating with the school. The two research questions explored in this study were, what are the best methods to communicate with parents and families in an urban elementary school? The second question was, how do parents perceive parent involvement with respects to their child's school? The methodology used in this particular study was called a mixed methods sequential explanatory study. This consisted of a quantitative and qualitative review. Before we go any further, let's look and see what action research really is. The review of literature on hand centers in the subsequent areas: parental engagement, benefits of parental engagement, communication barriers, educators' perceptions of parental engagement, and parental engagement and technology. The first thing I reviewed was, why does parent involvement matter? Now, let's take a look at what some key individuals say about parent engagement.
So the question is whether all of us, as citizens and as parents, are willing to do what's necessary to give every child a chance to succeed. That responsibility begins not in our classrooms, but in our homes.
A very important part of the educational process is to involve the parents.
To really involve parents and the entire community in ensuring that public education improves.
If we can have parental involvement, that's huge and terrific.
It is well documented and plain common sense
that parental involvement in a child's education boosts student learning and improves both behavior and student attendance.
Unfortunately, there are still studies coming out that show that many parents feel that the total responsibility for the education of their students is the schools and the teacher. And that's not true.
There are no excuses. Because when you are in the building, boys see a good example, girls see a good example, and children will change their behavior just because they know you.
When I walk into a school where the parent volunteers, community partners, I can just feel the difference in the building.
Our highest achieving kids always have parental support. What does that tell us? We've got to get parental support for more of our kids.
You've got to let your kid know you're invested. So when they come home, ask them, can I see your homework? Ask them, what did they do in school?
So that piece, that collaboration piece that I talked about before, more and more and more, I see that as the most important factor of helping kids learn.
Schools can't do it all by themselves. Okay? And if we don't find a ways to engage parents, then we're not going to get it done.
My mom showed up in my school, scared me to death. She would look the teacher in the eye and say, my child will get an A in this class. It's either going to be your fault or his fault. If it's his fault, I'll take care of him at home. But if it's your fault, I'm coming back here.
I'm telling you, if everybody who is a parent who is listening right now went to your school and said to the teacher, tell me what I can do to help you help my child,
even if
you would get a different level of respect.
Yes, you will.
And you would get a different level of return for your child.
Yes,
would you not?
Look, everybody knows the kids whose parents show up, you can't help it by human nature. You pay particular attention to those children.
I'm not going to deny it's difficult, because all the factors that we've been talking about all weekend play into that. The employment issues, let's just take one of them, and the stress of lower income families and just trying to exist make it difficult, obviously, to get involved. But I think we have to start from the belief, a real belief, that family engagement is not external to the process of education.
In the end, there is no program or policy that can substitute for a parent, for a mother or father who will attend those parent-teacher conferences, or help with homework, or turn off the TV, put away the video games, read to their child. I speak to you not just as a president, but as a father. When I say that responsibility for our children's education must begin at home, that is not a Democratic issue or a Republican issue. That's an American issue.
Findings. The first question asked parents, how do they find out information about what's going on in the school? And 100% of the parents stated they find out information through their children. Another question asked, well, how do they obtain that information from the children? Once again, the majority of parents stated that it's through conversation with their son or daughter, or it's a piece of paper, newsletter, brochure, flyer, stuffed in the child's backpack, which sometimes never sees the light of day. The second question asked parents, what was their preferred method of communication? No surprise to the researcher at hand, 100% of the parents said some type of form of technology. The first one was email. Parents prefer to receive information via email, and second behind email was cell phones. Several teachers reported in our building they use a program called Remind 101, which is a text-based program. The third question asked, what were the barriers present, which restricted parents from communicating with the school? And the number one response was they were only being called to school if their son or daughter did something bad. The second response was, they just did not have a relationship at all, or in some cases didn't even know the teacher's name. The action plan. Parent engagement perceptions have moved from seeming involvement by parents, such as volunteering for dances, field trip chaperones, and helping out in the main office, to a more family engagement viewpoint, where parents are involved with the strategy and implementation of school-wide programs. This swing has exposed challenges and barriers confronted by many schools as they endeavor to increase the level and type of parental engagement. Strategies to increase the level of parental engagement challenges schools to fulfill the state's statutory requirements and direction regarding parent engagement. The following section delivers two actionable strategies to address potential barriers and offer strategies as possible solutions to address such issues and challenges. Technology is the catchphrase in education these days. Many people see technology and communication as a system of parts. Symbiotically, when these parts work well together, success occurs. It is essential to acknowledge the noticeable role that technology plays in education in today's schooling. The researchers suggest the schools update the school's website immediately to offer interactive, educational, and easy-to-use features on the school website. These might include contact information for teachers and staff, an up-to-date and complete calendar, a regularly updated principal's newsletter, and a forum for interaction between parents. The researcher believes that providing parents with web-based information will enable them to instantly and easily learn more about their child's education. Lastly, the Action Research Study identified how parents preferred to be contacted. The overwhelming response requested communication through email and text. As a result of this request, the researcher will immediately begin to collect parents' emails and cell phone numbers by sending update and emergency contact information sheets home to parents to create various parent email distribution lists. For example, a distribution list for a classroom grade level school-wide. In addition, cell phone numbers will be added to the district's school-wide information system. An online professional development opportunity will be offered to all classroom teachers on the last day of school. The end goal will hopefully look like this.